in this program, we're like out in the real world and we're like figuring out why things are the way that they are.
And this program allows our students from Red Bluff to actually do field research at Lassen Volcanic, working closely with scientists from Ames.
You know, you go in, you make a set of observations, you can infer what might be the processes and what might be the explanation, but then you gotta go test that.
It's not like any science class we've ever taken. The whole year is based on one experiment and then how that, like the understanding of the experiment just evolves every time we have a meeting.
My name is Robert Cromwell. I'm the Parks Education Specialist, and so I'm fortunate enough to work with the Astrobiology program. And so here at this site, the students are out under teacher supervision. Rangers are out here like myself to very closely supervise the safety.
And today we are up here in the Warner Valley, actually looking at the hydrothermal features that are up here. So my name is Dave Michael. I teach chemistry, and then I'm also fortunate to be a part of what's a really unique program, Red Bluff High School. When the program first started, it was strictly an after-school program.
And we had about 6 students, I think, the first year. And it really started out as kind of just this mentorship, you know, matching some NASA scientists with some students from Red Bluff High and take them out in the park. And that was kind of the concept the first year. My name is Michael Kubo. I work at NASA Ames Research Center. I've been part of the program since, 2008. This is our 10th year. For about 4 years, it was a formal after-school program where we developed more course content, had sort of a logical theme that ran through the program, which was watersheds and the impact of volcanism on those watersheds. So about 6-7 years ago, we took another look at the program, and we decided to come to Warner Valley, do some scouting. We heard that there were some interesting hydrothermal features here that didn't exist anywhere else in the park that would give us a stronger tie-in to Mars.
And so what this contributes to is a body of research that NASA has at Lassen.
And through the years, we've just gotten more and more involved because Ames has gotten more and more interested in what's going on here.
We have examples within Lassen where volcanic activity, which to us seems rather inhospitable in many ways, actually creates environments that are quite hospitable for microorganisms. The other reason that we're so interested in Lassen is because the volcanic activity is not just something that happens on the Earth.
Yeah, Lassen is a better analog for certain environments on Mars than Yellowstone is, because the types of lava flows here in general are a little more similar to Mars. So Devil's Kitchen is acidic, and there's a lot of metal content in the water, and also the mineral deposits that you can see the beautiful colors on the rocks and in the outflow channels. In some ways, they're more similar to a particular environment on Mars. It's called Meridiani Planum. It was once an acidic water body. So that's why we come to sites like this. We study the microbial life growing here, the types of mineral deposits here, as an analog for what Meridiani Planum could have been like in the past.
And so as we're looking to Mars and trying to understand which places we should visit and which features we should look for, we'd be hard-pressed to do better than come to a place like Lassen to say, well, what are the things that we see and observe at these sites where we can support life, and what are the types of features we might look for that would indicate the presence of life?
So we came here, scouted for a summer, found some great sites, developed some course content around that.
And we slowly let the program grow to the point now where we have 20 students involved, and it's actually a class.
So that's where we've basically grown the program from 6 students after school hanging out with NASA scientists to 20 students as an official school program.
A high school class that goes for the whole school year, where we really have the luxury of starting out with a field trip like this with the basic observations, trying to ask some questions about why did we see what we saw, why did we see differences between sites.
So the students, this year we have 18 students, and it's a combination of juniors and seniors. And the juniors are first year interns, and the seniors are second year interns.
We come out here, we observe the sites, and then we try to think about, okay, well, why is like the temperature so high? Why is the pH so low?
The whole thing is just a great opportunity because it's not like any science class we've ever taken. just like being able to go out in the field and take samples, it was nice to have that side of it and create like your own experiment testing, you know, the microbes that we collect.
Yeah, we design experiments and then based on what we observe in the experiments, we can kind of like see why these observations are the way they are.
Really what we're trying to establish on top of anything else is critical thinking. And so one of the things we really want the students to take with them as they graduate is, you know, always try to ask why.
In this program, we're like making observations about our surroundings, testing and then forming hypotheses and then like figuring out why things are the way that they are.
The why of things is a really important aspect of understanding then how to manage most effectively and just going forward in your own life, you know, finding your own path.
So it's really like different, and the experience has showed me, oh, maybe I want to do research like as a career.
What we started to see is these students, as they graduate, go on to college, they're pursuing some of the science-related fields that they're actually studying here in the park.
And high school really doesn't touch on microbiology very much, and as you know, many high schools really don't offer geology either. And so two of the really key things for astrobiology, which is geologic process and microbiology, are really not something that high school students are exposed to.
I am really impressed at what these students are capable of. It's great for the students to have this experience at really college, you know, kind of college university level type of experience.
So in that sense, we're giving them a little bit broader exposure to some key science areas, and we're also exposing them to really a new thrust in science, and that is interdisciplinary science, where you bring geology together with microbiology, and for that matter, together with climatology.
And so a really important aspect of this, I would say, for the National Park Service is that they're acting as stewards.
And something that's really a close cousin to astrobiology is this whole idea of environmental stewardship. You know, you have to understand the environment in order to manage it.
So this is definitely, you know, it's an education program, very much science and curriculum-based, but also it's a stewardship program where the interns are volunteering and earning hours for the National Park Service and for Lassen Volcanic through their scientific research, through the year-long project they're doing, and also the process of communicating that to the public, which they do in a public event where they all will share their year-long adventure as well as their really intense, in-depth scientific research and results. They're communicating science. And so this is truly stewardship through science communication. And it's so important that parks have that. It's essential.
We really want students to be excited about what they're doing and to bring them out in the field, show them the tremendous scenery here, the environment here, just everything that the park has to offer, but also at the same time doing the science involved with it just really opens their eyes up.
Yeah, I mean, the name of the game is turning more students on to science, to astrobiology, to field work, hands-on science work.
And then taking it to another level, they are helping to inform decisions that will impact how we manage the resource. And they're a part of that, and they realize it, and you kind of see them, you know, their shoulders come up, and, you know, they really, you know, look them in the eyes, and they understand that what they're doing is important.
It's just a great opportunity, and we're lucky enough that our school is able to, you know, be in contact with NASA scientists and, you know, engaged in an experiment as big as this and connect it all to Mars.
I mean, it's awesome, really, is when students actually say it back to you before you get a chance to tell them. And so I had multiple students just today say how much fun and enjoyment they had doing field work, and the fact that they're out actually doing science and not just learning about it in the classroom. And as teachers, that's just, I mean, it's what we strive for.
I think the coolest thing is just the idea that Lassen can be used to study Mars. I just think it's really cool that we can come here and like observe microbes and then relate those to what scientists are doing out, like trying to find life in space. I think that's just really cool.